Good morning, students. In the last session, we have discussed about regulated power supply and half wave rectifier. So, what is the function of rectifier and what is the working of half wave rectifier, the ripple factor, and the average values? So, all these things we have discussed in the last session. Today, we will see about full wave rectifier. Today we will discuss about full wave rectifier. So in the full wave rectifiers, these are classified again two types: center tapped full wave rectifier and bridge rectifier. So here the full wave rectifiers are classified in two types. They are center tapped full wave rectifier. Second one is full wave bridge rectifier. So actually in the half wave rectifier, the efficiency is low and the ripple factor is high. So the half wave rectifier efficiency is 40.6%, the ripple factor is 1.21. The half wave rectifier utilizes only half of the cycle, the remaining cycle is wasted. So to overcome the drawbacks in the half wave rectifier, so we are using full wave rectifier. In the full wave rectifier, the two cycles are utilized. So this rectifier uses two diodes. The center tapped full wave rectifier uses two diodes. So it is the circuit diagram for center tapped full wave rectifier. It is a circuit diagram for center tapped full wave rectifier. See this circuit diagram. So it is the input signal. So here we are using two diodes, D1 and D2. So D1 and D2 are the two diodes. This is the center tapped transformer. So at the primary side, so we are applying the AC input voltage. At the secondary side, it is a center tapped transformer. So for example, if it is a 12 volts center tapped transformer, so between these two terminals we have 6 volts and between these two terminals we have 6 volts. See here, it is the working of center tapped full wave rectifier in the positive half cycle. In the positive half cycle, point A becomes positive with respect to point B. See here, it is point A, this one is point B. In the positive half cycle, point A becomes positive with respect to point B. Hence, diode D1 is forward biased. So D1 is in on state and diode D2 is in off state. Okay, see here. See in this circuit diagram, here A is positive with respect to B. So here in the positive half cycle, point A becomes positive with respect to point B. So that's why D1 becomes on. So D1 is forward biased. So D1 is in on state and D2 is in off state. Okay, so D2 is in off state. So here D1 is forward biased and D2 is reverse biased. So D2 is in open circuit condition, right? So here D1 is in short circuit condition. So D1 is in on state and D2 is in off state for the positive half cycle. So then the output voltage across the load is because of positive half cycle only. Okay, the output voltage across the load is because of the positive half cycle. So therefore the entire applied voltage will appear across the load resistor RL. For example, if VA is Vm sin theta, V0 is also same. So V0 equal to VA equal to Vm sin theta for the duration from 0 to
pi.
So from 0 to pi, V naught equal to Vi equal to Vm sin theta. Okay. So it is similar to half wave rectifier. It is similar to half wave rectifier. Up to this, it is similar to half wave rectifier. For negative half cycle, see the circuit diagram. For negative half cycle, so D1 becomes reverse biased and D2 becomes forward biased. So D1 it is in open circuit condition and D2 in short circuit condition. So for the negative half cycle of the input, point B becomes positive with respect to point A. So hence the diode D1 is in off state, the diode D1 is in off state and the diode D2 is in on state. Right? So then the output voltage across the load is because of negative half cycle. The output voltage is because of negative half cycle. So for positive and negative half cycles, the current flows in the same direction through the load. So in the half wave rectifier, there is no current flowing in the circuit in the negative half cycle. But here, for positive and negative half cycles, the current flows in the same direction through the load. So see here, in the positive half cycle, the current is flowing through the load, and in the negative half cycle also the current is flowing through the load. So therefore the entire applied voltage will appear across the load resistor RL. So from 0 to pi, V naught equal to Vi. So due to negative half cycle, the current is flowing through the load. Then from pi to 2 pi also, V naught equal to Vi. Whereas in half wave rectifier, from pi to 2 pi, the output will be 0. But here, from pi to 2 pi also, the output equal to the input. So V naught equal to Vi equal to Vm sin theta. Right? So it conducts in positive cycle and it conducts in negative cycle. So D1 conducts in positive cycle and D2 conducts in negative cycle. See here, see the input and output waveforms. It is the input waveform. So it is the output waveform. So here the two cycles are utilized. So in the positive cycle, D1 becomes forward biased. In the negative cycle, D2 becomes forward biased. So the two half cycles will be utilized. So that's why it is called full wave rectifier. So we are getting the complete input signal. Okay. So this waveform is due to positive cycle and this waveform is due to negative half cycle. So finally you will get this type of output waveform. Okay. So these are the input and output waveforms of the full wave center tapped full wave rectifier. Here also we have to calculate DC current, ripple factor, efficiency and output power. See here, first we are going to calculate the average or DC current. We are going to calculate the average current or DC current. So consider one cycle of the load current IL from 0 to pi. So to obtain the average value, which is DC value of load current. So consider the half cycle. So consider the half cycle. So from 0 to pi. Here the DC current IDC is 1 by pi integral 0 to pi IL d omega t. Here we are taking the load current from 0 to pi. So that's why here it is IDC equal to 1 by pi integral 0 to pi IL d omega t. So we know that IL equal to Im sin omega t. So it becomes 1 by pi integral 0 to pi आई एम साइन ओमेगा टी डी ओमेगा टी. ओके नाउ आई एम बाई पाई इट बिकम्स आई एम बाई पाई माइनस कास ओमेगा टी इंटीग्रल सॉरी जीरो टू द लिमिट्स आर जीरो टू पाई. सो इट बिकम्स आई एम बाई पाई माइनस कास पाई माइनस ऑफ माइनस कास जीरो. सो इट इज कास पाई इट इज कास जीरो. सो इट बिकम्स आई डी सी इज टू आई एम बाई पाई. आई डी सी इक्वल टू टू आई एम बाई पाई. सो वेर इज इन हाफ वेव रेक्टिफायर द डीसी करंट और एवरेज करंट इज आई एम बाई पाई बट हियर द डीसी करंट इज टू आई एम बाई पाई. सो दट इज द एवरेज आर डीसी करंट आई डी सी आर आई एवरेज. सो सेकेंड वन इज डीसी वोल्टेज आर एवरेज वोल्टेज. सो हियर वी डी सी इज आई डी सी इंटू आर एल. वी नो द आई डी सी इज टू आई एम बाई पाई that into RL. So then VDC becomes 2 VM by pi. VDC becomes 2 VM by pi. Here IDC is 2 IM by pi and IM is VM by RL. So I maximum current is, so it is maximum voltage VM by RL. Okay. So in the full wave rectifier, the DC current is 2 IM by pi. The full wave rectifier, the DC current is 2 IM by pi and the DC voltage is 2 VM by pi. 2 VM by pi. Next, we have to calculate the RMS value of load current. So, IRMS. IRMS. So, it is IRMS is root mean square current. So, it is square root of 1 by pi integral 0 to pi IL square d omega t. So this we can write square root of 1 by pi integral 0 to pi in place of IL. We can write IM sin omega t. So IL square means IM square sin square omega t d omega t. So from this, so we get IM into square root of 1 by pi 0 to pi. So it is 1 minus cos 2 omega t by 2. Okay, so sin square omega t. So integral sin square omega t. So that becomes 1 minus cos 2 omega t by 2 into d omega t. So here I am square root of 1 by 2 pi. So integral 0 to pi 1 d omega t minus 0 to pi cos 2 omega t d omega t. So if you apply the limits here, then we get IM square root of 1 by 2 pi, pi minus 0, minus 1 by 2 into sin 2 pi minus sin 2 of 0. Okay. So then finally you get IM into square root of pi by 2 pi. So here in the full wave rectifier, the RMS current is IM by root 2. So from this equation, so we have derived RMS current is IM by root 2. So whereas DC current is 2 IM by pi, but the AC current is IM by root 2. Okay. So next one is RMS value of load voltage, VRMS. So we know VRMS is IRMS into RL. So from this, so substitute IRMS, that is IM by root 2, then VRMS becomes IM by root 2 into RL. That is the RMS value of load voltage. Next, so we had to find out DC output power. See here, the DC output power PDC is IDC square into RL. So P equal to I square into RL. Here the DC power is, so IDC square into RL. So substitute IDC. So it is 2 IM by pi whole square into RL. So IDC is 2 IM by pi. So then the DC power becomes 4 by pi square into IM square into RL. So the DC power is 4 by pi square in 4 by pi square im square into rl. Here idc is 2 im by pi and im is vm by rl. So that is the dc output power. It is the dc output power. So next one is ac output power. Here PAC is IRMS square into RL. PAC is IRMS square into RL. That is where IRMS is IM by root 2. Then we get AC output power is IM square by 2 into RL. AC output power is IM square by 2 into RL. That is the AC output power. So next, rectifier efficiency. So we know that the rectifier efficiency is defined as the ratio of output DC power to AC input power. So output power is DC power and the input power is AC power. So it is a ratio of output DC power to AC input power. So efficiency is PDC by PAC. So if you substitute PDC and PAC values here, then you get 0.812. That means the percentage efficiency is 81.2%. So the full wave, the center tapped full wave rectifier efficiency is 81.2%. Here the two cycles are utilized. So in the positive cycle, D1 is conducting, D2 is in off state. In the negative cycle, D2 is conducting and D1 is in off state. So that is the rectifier efficiency is 81.2%. Next, ripple factor. Ripple factor. So here, ripple factor is square root of IRMS square by IDC square minus 1. So substitute IRMS and IDC. So IRMS is IM by root 2 and IDC is 2IM by pi. So substitute IRMS and IDC values here. Then you will get ripple factor is 0.48. So the full wave rectifier ripple factor is 0.48. Here the efficiency is more and the ripple factor is less compared to half wave rectifier. The full wave rectifier has high efficiency and low ripple factor. So next, advantage. Advantage of full wave rectifier. So here the efficiency is high, the ripple factor is low and the transformer utilization factor is high. The ripple factor is low and the efficiency is high. These are the advantages of the center tapped full wave rectifier. When it comes to disadvantages, so it has high peak inverse voltage. It has high peak inverse voltage. Here the peak inverse voltage is 2V maximum. The peak inverse voltage is 2V maximum. And the cost of center tap transformer is high. And high peak inverse voltage. It has high peak inverse voltage. And it is very difficult to identify the exact polarity of the secondary winding. So here we are using the center tapped transformer, so that's why it is very difficult to identify the exact polarity of the secondary winding. So in the secondary side we are having 3 wires, so it is very difficult to identify the exact polarity of the secondary winding. So these are the advantages and disadvantages of the center tapped full wave rectifier. Next one is full wave bridge rectifier. So to overcome the drawbacks of center tapped full wave rectifier, we are using bridge rectifier. So the use of center tapped transformer in full wave rectifier can be eliminated by using a bridge rectifier. Here we are using 4 diodes. The 2 diodes will operate at a time for each half cycle. The bridge rectifier, see the circuit diagram of bridge rectifier. So it looks like a bridge. Here it has 4 diodes, D1, D2, D3, D4 and one input transformer. So this in the function of the input transformer is it step down the input voltage. That depends on the rating of the transformer. So it uses four diodes. The two diodes will operate at a time for each half cycle. So in the positive half cycle, two diodes are connecting and the two diodes are in off state. In the negative half cycle, remaining two diodes will connect and another two diodes will be in off state. In the positive half cycle, point A becomes positive with respect to point B. So here A is positive with respect to point B. Then D1, D4 in off state and D2, D3 in on state. So here the diodes D2 and D3 are conducting in the positive half cycle. In the positive half cycle, A is positive with respect to B. So that's why D2 and D3 are conducting. So diodes D2 and D3 are in on state and D1 and D4 are in off state. Okay, so in the positive half cycle, D1, D4, these two diodes will not conduct. So D2, D3 are on and diodes D1, D4 are off. So then the voltage is taken across the load. Here the current direction is through D2, RL, D3. See here in the circuit diagram, the current direction is in the positive half cycle. The current direction is D2, RL, D3. It is in the positive half cycle. So the entire applied voltage will appear across the load resistor RL. It is similar to in the full wave, center tapped full wave rectifier. So Vi equal to Vm sin theta and V0 equal to Vi. So from 0 to pi duration. So from 0 to pi, output voltage equal to input voltage. So V0 equal to Vi equal Vm sin theta. Okay. So for the negative half cycle, point B becomes positive with respect to point A. In the negative half cycle, point B becomes positive with respect to point A. So due to this, D2, D3 are in off state. So here these two diodes, D2 and D3 are in off state and D1 and D4 are in on state. D1 and D4 are in on state. Okay. Then the voltage is taken across the load. The current direction is through here. The current direction is through D4, RL, D1. D4, RL, D1. That is in the negative half cycle. In the positive half cycle, the current direction is through D2, RL, D3. But in the negative half cycle, the current direction is through D4, RL and D1. So the entire applied voltage will appear across the load resistor RL. So from pi to 2 pi duration also, output voltage is similar to input voltage. So V0 and Vi equal to Vm sin theta. That is from pi to 2 pi. So at a time, two diodes are in conduction mode and two diodes are in off state. So these are the input and output waveforms. So here the output waveforms are similar to center damped full wave rectifier. So almost two cycles are utilized. So the efficiency, the ripple factor, so and IDC values, so all these parameters are same exactly as in the center tapped full wave rectifier. So it is similar to center tapped full wave rectifier. So efficiency is 81.2% and ripple factor is 0.48. Okay. So when it comes to advantage, here no need of center tapped transformer. no need of center tap transformer, and the peak inverse voltage is less. So in this bridge rectifier, the peak inverse voltage is V maximum, but in the center tap full wave rectifier, the peak inverse voltage is 2 V maximum. And it has high transformer utilization factor. The bridge rectifier has high transformer utilization factor. So one drawback is it requires 4 diodes. It requires 4 diodes. The remaining efficiency and ripple factor, everything is similar to center tapped full wave rectifier. So these are the advantages and disadvantages of bridge rectifier. So only center tap transformer can be eliminated in the bridge rectifier. So if you compare the half wave rectifier, center tap full wave rectifier and bridge rectifier, see here the number of diodes used in half wave rectifier, it is 1, in center tap full wave rectifier it is 2, and in full wave bridge rectifier the number of diodes are 4. So here the efficiency in half wave rectifier is 40.6. So here in the full wave rectifier it is 81%. The ripple factor is in half wave rectifier it is 1.21. In the full wave rectifier it is 0.48. The peak inverse voltage is V maximum in half wave rectifier, 2 V maximum in full wave rectifier, and again V maximum in bridge rectifier. Here F0 is, so Fin in half wave rectifier, 2 Fin in full wave rectifier. And transformer utilization factor is in half wave rectifier it is 28.6%, in full wave rectifier 69.2%, and in bridge rectifier it is 81.2%. And the form factor is in half wave rectifier it is 1.57, in full wave rectifier it is 1.11, and the peak factor is half wave rectifier it is 2, and the full wave rectifier it is 1.41. So these are the different parameters in the three rectifiers. So half wave, center tap full wave, and bridge rectifiers. Okay, with this I am going to stop the presentation. Thank you.